Amen. You may be seated. Turn to page 818, Great is Thy Faithfulness, one of Mr. Ashman's favorite songs. We want you to sing it like a celebration today, all right?
Great is Thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with Thee. Thou changest not Thy compassion, they fail not. As Thou hast said, Thou forever will be. Great is Thy faithfulness.
Eternally, oh, what a day, pray. shout the victory, break through the blues. Some golden day break for me, for you.
It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. That's what this is. It was the best of times because the cement is going to heaven. He's in heaven today with my mother. That was the worst of times because a generation is moving on. Tom Brokaw recently wrote a book about the generation past, the great generation past. We have a tremendous responsibility to honor these folks. That who, I never heard this man say a cuss word in his whole life. Whole life. Tremendous. I remember sitting in his church at different places. Sometimes when he came and said, "You're going?" A tremendous man. I'd seen with a high school friend last night. It says to me, said, "If there ever was a man who went to heaven, it was your dad." And we're here to celebrate a life that is tremendous. And one thing it does do for me, it makes me more committed than ever, ever to be responsible to my family and to people that I see daily, to be the kind of man only I could never be the kind of man he was, but maybe I can be just a little part and share some goodness in somebody's life. May we pray. Our Father in heaven, how great is your name. Your love reaches to us through the valleys and the mountains, the suns comes up, and the diverse and unique generation and time. We have wars and rumors of wars. We have problems, but your love surpasses all generations. Thank you, God, for allowing me to be a part of this family. Be with my mother. Be with my dad. Be with Jake Whitmer. Be with Chris Eshelman. Be with a tremendous generation past. And only I pray that you will teach us through this service today not to say goodbye, but to say hello to a unique and new outlook. I ask this in your precious name. Amen.
Once upon a roadside crisis that stayed the cyclone, he took a moment for a word of prayer. He called God on the telephone, and what he said is unspoken by anyone. But he listened, he listened, and then out came the sun.
Thank you, Melvin, and thank you, Tabernacle, for allowing us this time to remember and honor our father. I just want to give a special honor to Aunt Suetta and Uncle Chris Jr. and his wife Mary and you folks that drove all the way from Orangeburg, Steve and Johnny and Bobby, and I just so appreciate that. Dad used to say, I'm a very simple man. God had to make things very simple for me. And I know the children probably said, I know you heard this a few times, but if you may not have heard this, he would say, I was born in May. That's the fifth month. If you double it, that's the 10th day, his birthday. And you double that was the year he was born, was 1920 or 21.